ربي بالمصطفى. بلغ مقاصدنا
to introduce our next guest, but let me tell you a bit about him. He arrived in Britain in 1977 and has been working hard to promote Islam's spiritual message amongst the native British since arrival. Originally from Sudan, he organized and started his first program at London's Central Mosque at Regent's Park, which is currently known as Saturday Circle. He then went on to participate in the development of the North London Community Centre, where he met His Royal Highness, the Prince of Wales, for the first time, as he had helped in raising the funds from late Royal Highness King Fahad bin Abdulaziz. He still continues to work with His Royal Highness, the Prince of Wales. He participates in promoting Britain and British Islam through the Commonwealth and Foreign Office. The Sheikh currently works at Islamia School Centre, which was founded by Yusuf Islam in 1983 as the first Muslim school in the world. His job is to promote the Muslim schools at home and abroad through workshops and conferences. He's also chairman of Ulfa Aid, a registered charity in London. I met him a few years back in London and we have kept in touch. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a Bradfordian a welcome to Sheikh Babikir Ahmed Babikir.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Bismillahir Ladhi La Yadurru Ma'a Ismihi Shay'un Fil Ardi Wa La Fis Sama'i Wa Huwa As-Sami'ul Alim. Bismillahir Majriha Wa Mursaha Inna Rabbi La Ghafurur Rahim. Walhamdulillah. Alhamdulillahi Ladhi Khalaqa As-Samawati Wal Arda Wa Ja'ala Adh-Dhulumati Wan Nur. Thumma Alladhina Kafaru Bi Rabbihim Ya'dilun. هو الذي خلقكم من طين ثم قضى أجلا وأجل مسمى عنده ثم أنتم تمترون وهو الله في السماوات وفي الأرض يعلم سركم وجهركم ويعلم ما تكسبون وما ظن الذين يفترون على الله الكذب يوم القيامة إن الله لذو فضل على الناس ولكن أكثرهم لا يشكرون وكأي من آية في السماوات والأرض يمرون عليها وهم عنها معرضون صدق الله العظيم وبلغ رسوله الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والصلاة والسلام على أفضل خير الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا إلى يوم الدين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي ربي أودعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي ونعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين My dear brothers and sisters in Iman, I know you have been sitting for a long time, and I know people wanted you to come earlier so that you can do a good job. And I know you have children. As a teacher, children have to go to school early. It's not good for children to arrive late, because this will give a very bad example for them in their future life. So I'm not going to speak for very long. And I'm just going to say something briefly about the important role of a mother in the house. A lot of us come from homes whereby our mothers did not go to schools or they studied very little. But if you look at them, especially those who are older in age, they devote their life and they give all their time and their love for even the children who are old enough to have children. Those who are in good jobs, earning good money, they do a lot for them. But never I see us as people who are working hard achieving success in this world, thinking back about those people who deprive themselves from the pleasure of this world by providing for us the means to become who we are. If you are a graduate, if you are working in a good job, if you are an intellectual person, you have done your research in university, think back to your mother, your grandmother, who have done a lot for you, and please be grateful to Allah by thanking that mother. There is a wisdom that I have learned from those who taught me that in this world, without our parents, we have nothing. But specifically without our mothers, we have nothing. We need to always think about our mother and her role in the house and what she does. And subhanAllah, living in this country for almost 40 years, working with all communities, and specifically with the Pakistani communities, I always tell to the boys in the Pakistani community, you are like royal members of a family. You work out, you do your jobs, you go to college, you come back, you put your shoes on the table, and you demand your food to be served, you demand your clothes to be closed, to be washed and ironed for you. And subhanAllah, who does these things? Either your sister, your mother, your grandmother, your auntie, or your wife, and in some cases, your daughter. So we need to give back, and that giving back is by showing gratitude, thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what He has given us, especially in this time when we see in this country, with all the modern technology we have, we can't keep a family together. And you know why? Your grandparents married for 60, 70 years. Your parents have been married for the last 30, 40 years. And young kids with all the education and all the blessings they have, they can't keep a marriage for a year because we are not grateful. We are not thanking Allah enough for the women in the house. Women are being put down. Women have been put down a lot from the beginning of the history of mankind. Women initially were oppressed and abused, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent to a community who used to bury their daughters alive. Allah said in the Quran, "A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, fa idhal mawudatu su'ilat." When that little girl, innocent girl, who just came to become a teenager, is taken and buried without any reason for burial. If today this happened, it will be headline news. But the Arabs, those Arabs, subhanAllah, used to bury their daughters alive. Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, reports when he did this to one of his children, he says she was wiping the sand off his beard and asking him, "What are you doing, father?" But he couldn't tell her because he's doing something that no parent who have love for their children in his heart will do. No parents will do that. And this is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us as human beings to love. And you know where the love comes from? From the womb of the mother. The womb of the mother is where the love is built. Your mother is carrying you 9 months in her belly, delivering you in difficulty and troubles. Allah said in the Quran, حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُمْ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنًا. His mother carried him in pain and delivered him in difficulty. If she dies, she dies a martyr. And then you are a baby, looked after. You can't eat yourself, you can't feed yourself, you can't clean yourself. And subhanAllah, if your mother, subhanAllah, could not clean you, who will clean you? She did not feed you, who will feed you? When you have your own children and they need cleaning, you run away from them. You say, "No, it's not my job, it's the mother's job." But subhanAllah, somebody did this for you when you were young. You need to thank Allah for that person. And then the mother look after you when you are in school, when you go to university, when you go to college. I have mothers who ring me and they say to me, "Sheikh, I have my son who is working so hard and he is fasting and he have exam in university. Can he break his fast?" I say, "How old is he?" "Well, he's 20, he's 21, he's 22. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. Why should he break his fast? People are working in hot countries, carrying in their bags in Karachi, in Lahore, in Arab countries like Aden and Swiss Canal. People are working and they die from the work, but they never break their fast. But this is because the mother loves her child. He doesn't want to break his fast, but his mother says, "I will find the fatwa for you so you can break your fast, son," out of love. Then when you get married, she's there. When you have children, who looks after them? Your mother. When your children are getting married, who buy the presents for them? Your mother. When they are ill, who cater for them? Your mother. If they die, who cries most for them? Your mother. صدق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The messenger has spoken the truth when he said to the companion, أمك ثم أمك ثم أمك. Your mother, your mother, your mother. So my advice is, please, let us turn the table over, change the attitude, show respect to the women. I always read about the history of Europe. When you go back 100 years ago, women in this country were chaining themselves to the rails, asking for votes. They couldn't vote. Whereby the queen of Sheba, Bilqis, was the queen in her people long time ago. There were women in Africa, women in Asia, women in Arabia who were ruling, who were leading the communities. Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha was the richest woman in Arabia. She stood by the Prophet. She asked to marry him. She supported him. He loved her because of what she did to him. Khadija, subhanAllah, 1400 years ago, and here in this country, in Britain, a country where freedom is supposed to be, democracy is seated in the House of Parliament in London, by the Thames, women couldn't vote. They have to change themselves. But not just that, I was shocked when I heard in Switzerland, women were given the vote in the 70s, in early 70s. They were not allowed to vote. The Church of England used not to allow women to touch the Bible because they're not clean. In France, women were considered to be shaitan, the devil, استغفر الله العظيم. Women are a gift from Allah. The first gift Allah gave to a human being is a woman. When Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, who was in paradise, enjoying himself, turned and looked at the malaika in groups worshipping Allah, and he said to Allah, Almighty God, I feel alone. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to him, we will fulfill you. The fulfillment was giving him the first ni'mah in the form of a woman. From him, he created his partner. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَغَ لَكُم مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا. It is he, Allah, who created for you from yourself partners that you can dwell with them in peace and tranquility. The husband goes out, he's in trouble, his boss is giving him headache, his car is not driven well, he's having too many difficulties and problems, he comes home, who take away that pain? His wife. Who support him when his pocket is empty? His mother. Who look after his children when life is difficult? His grandmother. Every time you look at homes when there is security, there is peace, there is love, you find good women. Behind every good man, there is always a good woman. And I remind you, look at the greatest men who walked in this earth. The greatest men. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they were looked after by women. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, his grandmother prayed, oh Allah, please give me a child. If you give me a child, I will raise him to serve you in the temple. When the child was born, she was a woman, because in that time women has no place. She said, oh Allah, but I have a woman. What am I going to do with her? Subhanallah. Allah says, no, don't worry about her. We will give her the best gift. And the best gift was Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. And she raised him. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam had no father, but his mother brought him up to be the best of the men, the man who is full of mercy, compassion, love. And he says, وَبَرًّا بِوَالِدَتِي. Allah Almighty God made me loving, kind, lenient, gentle, generous to my mother. This is Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. وَبَرًّا بِوَالِدَتِي. If you go to bed at night and your mother is angry with you and you die, forget about heaven. For indeed you missed it in this world. Heaven is beneath your mother's feet, not literally, but because if you please her, you please Allah. رضا الله برضا الوالدين. The acceptance of Allah and their happiness is through the happiness of your parents. الوالدين أوسط أبواب الجنة. The parents are the middle door of heaven. You need to please your mother. Your mother is important. Your mother is important. I can't repeat it enough. I taught for 30 years in this country. I keep telling the boys, don't go home and make havoc and dirty yourself and dirty your room and make your life miserable because you make your mother's life miserable. Help your mother. Support your mother. Good men are always beside their mothers. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the seerah, you always hear it in the mawlid. كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يخدم أهله. He صلى الله عليه وسلم used to serve his family. Meaning, He used to serve his wives, support them, stand by them, love them, show them care. And subhanAllah, today we don't do that because we are men. That's wrong. And women are to blame as well because they raise the boys differently than the girls. The girls are to serve. The boys, no, you should be served. No. Women has to change their attitude too. Boys and girls are there to share. If Rasulullah sallam used to serve his family, كَانَ يَخْصِفُ نَعْلَهُ. He used to mend his shoes when they are broken. وَيَرْقَعُ ثَوْبَهُ. And he used to mend his clothes when they are ripped. وَيَحْلِبُ شَاتَهُ. He used to milk his own goat, صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَيَمْشِي مَعَ الْأَرْمَلَةَ وَالْخُدَّامِ. He used to walk with those who are servants. Today we don't even talk to them properly. He used to walk with them, enjoy their company, and those who are widows. Rasulullah sallam used to love women who lost their husband because they devote their life for their children. Many young women who are good, they are losing their husband. They are young, just 30 years old, 35 years old. They say, I'm not going to get married. I'm going to look after my children. Subhanallah. Look at this. This is something amazing. Devoting their life for their children, although they have their own life to look after, to go and get married and enjoy themselves. A man, when he loses his wife, the first thing he thinks about, where is my next wife? No, this is not the way to think. The way to think, if to get married, is to fulfill your deen. But the way to think is to look after the children Allah gave to you. It's a gift. In this country today, everything is easy. Wallah, everything is easy. Look at Europe. Look at Europe, subhanAllah. A lot of people coming from Africa, from Asia, and they are coming through the Mediterranean. They die to come to Europe. It's full of foreigners. Do you know what they want? Not to come to Europe. They want to come to England. Not to go to Scotland or Wales or go to Ireland. They want England. Because when you ask them why, well, in England there is justice. In England there is peace. And in England there is jobs and education and medicine that you can get free. I want to raise my children in England. Allah bless your grandparents and your parents who crossed the oceans to come and bring you here. And today I look at young Pakistanis, Indian, Bengalis, African kids, Arab kids, who are, mashallah, professionals. Some of them in parliament, MPs. Some of them are in the House of Lords. I say, thank your mother. Maybe she was an illiterate. She couldn't read. Maybe she couldn't even understand Islam properly. But she devoted herself and served you like a servant to become the man you are today or the woman you are today. We need to thank Allah for women and ask Allah to give us tawfiq to always be among those people who will do the best for our women. I'm going to conclude by telling you a short wisdom I was mentioning earlier. And this wisdom, please take it seriously, because we live in an age and in a world we're not really dying because of disease. We're not really dying because of we don't have. We are dying because of depression. We are dying because of eating and drinking too much. We are dying because we are neglecting everyone that came from the womb and trying to serve the world. Al-aqrabuna awla bil ma'ruf. The next of kin, the relatives, are the most deserved of your help. The wisdom goes like this. The wise man says, Salamatul jismi fi qillati al-ta'am. The safety of your physical body, which is an amana Allah gave to you, you should never ruin it. You should never go out like some of the children today, go and put a lot of tattoos in their bodies, go and pierce their ears, their lips. No, you are not supposed to do that. Your body is something Allah gave to you to look after, to clean, to look smart, to look absolutely handsome or beautiful in front of everybody. For Allah commanded the Prophet when he goes to do da'wah, وَثِيَابَكَ فَطَهِّرْ. And your appearance must always be the best appearance of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. You should look good, not look shabby. Look like a Muslim. And therefore here, by looking after the body, the wisdom is to eat little, drink little. Allah said in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا O you who believe, كُلُوا وَشَرَبُوا Eat and drink, halal and طيبة, lawful and good. So you are allowed to eat halal, but must be good food, not old food, not out of date food, not smelly food. You pass sometime through halal butcher shop, you smell the meat, don't buy it. Boycott it, because we are supposed to eat good meat, not bad meat. Good food, because it is going to damage your health. Healthy food is good. Halal and tayyiba. But That is the condition. Wala tusrifu. You should never overindulge in eating. Don't eat too much. Don't drink too much. Look at today, people in America, in this country, are dying because they are obese. Astaghfirullah. They can't even carry them to hospital. They can't get them out of the door of their bedroom where they were running like kids. Young, agile. They have to break the windows to take them out. They don't even have the right bed. They have to build a special bed. In hospital, when they have an operation, they don't have the right theater to put them in. They have to build proper theaters for them. So please, don't indulge too much in eating. And don't waste the food at home. Remember, there are people who are hungry. When you watch the television, children are running to take the grain of the food that has been thrown from the plains. And we have the ni'mah here. We need to be grateful. Secondly, salamatuddin fi ghillatil atham. The safety of your religion is to always watch the side of committing haram. We are trying to do a lot, pray and fast and giving charity, but we are not noticing Iblis is encouraging us to backbite, to spread rumors, to say bad things, to insult our parents, to not disrespect the old people. Astaghfirullah. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the one who does not respect the one who is old is not one of us. The one who cheats is not one of us. The one who lies is a hypocrite. Come on. This is the teaching of our beloved Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We should take it seriously. If we want to be good in our religion, strong in our iman, save ourselves. Save ourselves. And the last part of the wisdom, which is so important, salamatuddin. Okay? Min al-ikthar fi salatu wa salam alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you want to save your religion, then make a lot of salawat for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala Sayyidina Muhammad, Nabiya al-Rahma wa Hadiya al-Umma, أول من تنشق عن أهل الأرض ويدخل الجنة النبي المبعوث رحمة للعالمين وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا إلى يوم الدين. May Allah bless me and bless you and guard me and guard you. May Allah give us tawfiq and jazakum Allah for raising the funds. May Allah give you success here and hereafter, and may Allah put it in your books to be for you in the day of judgment. يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون. The day where no children, no money will benefit you. إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. Only the one who come to Allah with a pure heart. جزاكم الله خير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. شكرا.
يا ربي بالمصطفى.